This is supposed to be a hotel. It feels more like an orphanage.
It works.
It's all their fault. Girls. Girls.
Think what? Now. I have to make sure not to get caught. Oh, God, I hope they don't find out.
Young lady, you can't wander around like this. Well, there one
coming from room 213. Who's wasting my time?
This is supposed to be a hotel. It feels more like an orphanage.
Elisa? Where did everybody go? I shouldn't have encouraged Lynn to take part in the contest. And maybe I wouldn't have almost lost an arm. What was going through your head, Lynn? Power! It won't work! Locked. hurt me! Wake up, Jen. It's only a bad dream. Mephistopheles. I've always hated it.
Counting to three. Two. Two and a half? Ready or not, here I come. Young lady. I'm so tired of all this. I just want a break from it all.
Ugh, bitch! I beg you!
Away! Porcelain can hear us and see us. Ugh! Did you hit me? Ugh! Did you hit me?
Gets any work done around here is me.
It's all their fault. It would be best if I just told him I don't work with crybabies.
Yes, please! Yes, I did it!
While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off. The only one who actually gets any work done around here is me. It would be best if I just told him I don't work with crybabies.
Oh no, what could the code be?
Have they completed their chores? Obviously not. This is supposed to be a hotel. It feels more like an orphanage.
Only to other hotel rooms.
Girls. Filthy girls.
actually gets any work done around here.
It's all their fault. While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off.
In order to factory reset your save, insert the following code. 3, 2, 1, 4.
Have they completed their chores? Obviously not.
French window. Working my ass off. These cages doing here? Felton? Gallo? So, this is the real reason why Rosso Gallo closed its doors. Dying like that, painfully, it would have been the same for any other person, especially after everything they went through. The mirror. It couldn't have shattered by itself. I saw it.
What's going on? Mommy is coming.
Andy, don't.
Jennifer, don't make me lose my patience.
Shh, shh. Calm down, calm down. Everything is fine. Mommy is here.
The master key.
This is supposed to be a hotel, but it feels more like an orphanage.
Mommy is exhausted. One of these days, you're all going to make me crazy.
I can't take it anymore.
Not quite, young lady.
What do you want? Come get it. Where were you?
Where were you, tough? I'll show you, bitch.
Where are you?
You bitch!
I will make you regret ever being born!
Where were you?
Yes, do you think you're gone?
Jennifer!
Of course you can hear us. And see us.
Wanna play tough? I'll show you, bitch!
me.
Oh, God.
I'm counting to three. I find you. Jennifer? While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off. I'm so tired of all this. I just want a break from it all. Young lady. Didn't need desperate children. Thank you.
I come!
Come here. I won't hurt you. Migraine. And it's all their fault.
I just want to get away from this place!
I'm counting to three. One, two, two and a half. Ready or not, here I come.
Chores? Obviously not.
Felton? Gallo? So, this is the real reason why Rosso Gallo closed its doors. Dying like that, painfully, it would have been the same for any other person, especially after everything they went through.
Ah!
break from it all.
While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off.
Fuck,
young lady, do you think you're really going to get away with this?
When I find you,
Jennifer!
Locked. I shouldn't have encouraged Lynn to take part in the contest. Maybe I wouldn't have almost lost an arm. What was going through your head, Lynn?
Thank you.
Even Andrea must have been young at some point. So, prior to the fire, the nuns were busy cultivating the Ashmund Faust. Ashmund's parents have done a great deal for this town, even promoting theatrical masterpieces. Locked. Locked.
Still no news regarding last night's massacre at the peaceful residence of Cerro Oscuro, where the body of Richard Felton, a well-known notary, was found burnt in his own home. The man who was legally registered as Jennifer Richard Dean Felton and was found completely drenched in kerosene. The body of 38-year-old Gloria Ashman was also found at the scene. She was his personal assistant and a former nun at the Cristo Morente convent. Her body was found mutilated after she was reported thrown out a courtyard-facing window, apparently following a heated argument. The neighbors claim to have spotted a distinctive woman lurking around the area, having parked a white van nearby.
Missing. February 8, 1971. Celeste Felton, 13 years old. Beloved adopted daughter of Richard Felton and Ariana Gallo. You ran away from home, isn't that so? Why did you end up in this godforsaken place? Assigned by Flemington Institute to the Foster Home and Work Project at the Ashman Inn, 1973. Jennifer, just over 2 years older. Unknown parents. It's you, isn't it? Celeste Felton.
Miss, Mr. Ashman is waiting for you. Did you say Reed? Are you a relative?
More like an old family friend.
Please come in, Miss Reed. Come in. Don't be afraid. I don't bite. What is Reed?
Good evening, Mr. Ashman.
You've certainly come a long way. You have gone from simple larceny and battery all the way to homicide and arson. Are you here to broaden your resume?
Do you remember me?
I'll never forget a face. Maybe because I don't have one anymore. I know exactly why you're here. The same exact reason why that son of a bitch Felton ended up like cooked meat. Whatever happened to Celeste Felton?
I have here a dossier from the Flemington Girls Institute granting custody of 15-year-old girl Jennifer and certifying that she is to be a housekeeper at this hotel. Celeste Felton and the girl in the photo are the same person, aren't they?
That girl was simply an orphan. A homeless nobody. And so I decided to take custody of her.
And she just so happened to be the adoptive daughter of your former hated business partner Felton by pure coincidence? I don't buy it. So, you're saying that besides synthesizing pharmaceutical drugs and spreading diseases, Mr. Felton and yourself were all dedicated to helping homeless minors?
It was never about synthesizing a disease. Because the disease never existed.
And the moths?
Woken up at last.
Hey!
I barely touched her!
It was just a bad dream.
No! It wasn't a dream!
I found you at the bottom of the stairs.
You hit your head and lost a lot of blood.
It was as if you were dead, Jim.
Andrea went crazy!
You must eat or drink something, young lady.
She wanted to kill me!
That's not possible, Jennifer. Andrea was with me.
Here you go. Drink up.
I am sure of what I saw.
Everything is all right now. Calm down.
There was also a large man. He had a strange wooden stick shaped like a spine.
Poor Slim.
That man is dead, young lady.
No, I saw him. He was the one who pushed me down the stairs. You called him Wyman.
That thing is no longer Professor Wyman.
Andrea! That man is dead. And has been for a long time. He hung himself. You see, you were just dreaming.
I don't understand.
Jen, you have to calm down now.
You believe me, Lynn, don't you? You believe me, right?
She should get some rest now.
Jen, if you need anything...
I'm here for you.
Say goodbye. Party first from my eyes. If you leave me, are you sure you miss me? If you fly, you lose something in the sky.
Are you new
here? Listen to me.
Excuse me? Are you new?
I suppose so.
I love that song. Where are you from?
Flemington Girls Institute.
What did you do?
What do you mean?
If you get transferred here, it means you are a real problem.
Listen, I'm not up for making conversation.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, I guess. I was hoping we would get to know each other better. That's all.
I'm into illegal organ and drug trafficking. In my spare time, I exchange sex for cigarettes.
Nice. I was expecting more like controversial political activist, promoter of black slavery and preservation of the Aryan race.
Only in my spare time. Very well, you're right. I'm a real handful. Now, if you will excuse me.
The pleasure was all mine.
Is there something in the sky?
You have to wake up. I beg you, wake up!
Shit, they drugged you. Listen, you have to leave. You have to get away from this place.
This story again?
Everything you said before, I believe you. Porcelain and everything else you saw.
You heard Andrea. He hung himself years ago.
It's him, isn't it? Professor Albert Elias Wyman. The same walking stick you were talking about. See?
It was all an act. There was no body. And if there had been, it wouldn't have been his.
I don't understand.
There's no time to explain. They know who you are. They know.
What are you talking about? Why didn't you ever say anything to me?
I tried to warn you. I tried to get you to leave. But you never understood, for fuck's sake!
Why? Who do they think I am?
Celeste Felton.
Me? No, I don't know. Oh God, Lynn, I can't remember!
They found you and they brought you here to use you. And now that they are sure of who they think you are, you have to run!
Fucking hell, Lynn, just tell me!
That drug. The disease!
And what does that have to do with me?
Your birth mother. She used loads of it. You got it from her. It's a part of you. Your organism hasn't shown any side effects. Your body lives in harmony with it. You can even control it. And they know it. Look me in the eyes, Jen. Look at me. You mustn't do anything or trust anyone.
Is this the reason why we met? Have you been pretending to be my friend this whole time?
No, Jen. It had nothing to do with this. I've always been honest with you.
The moth perceives the presence of a possible threat to her throne. She does everything that she is capable of to maintain control over the others. Therefore, eliminating the threat.
Telephone. It's coming from Ashman's office. Locked. Oh, there has to be another way. Locked. 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 He's sleeping. I'll have to be as quiet as possible. missed it by a second. Wait, what's that? Maybe they left a voicemail.
Ashmeda? Hi, Stefano. It's me, Ariana. I know it was you earlier. I know it was you all those other times. I beg you. Stop tormenting us. I beg you, please, stop. I'm a married woman now, whether you like it or not, so get over it. And as for Richard, despite not having a choice, I stayed by his side when he endured all that shit that you put him through. Let us deal with our pain. Forget about us. Forget about me. Have some respect for us, a godforsaken couple who will never see their little girl ever again. I wish you could understand. Leave us be.
Ariana? Richard? No, it can't be. It can't be them. It must be a coincidence, Jen. This is me. It feels like an eternity has passed since I ran away from home. Jesus! I wonder if they were aware of all the abuses caused by their son to his...
Mom! Dad!
Is this what you were looking for?
Mr. Ashman, please, lower that gun!
I don't want to hurt you. It's not my intention.
Why won't you let me go, then?
I have no choice, Celeste!
I am not Celeste!
Quit the act! You're the only one who can stop it!
Please, Mr. Ashman, I beg of you, let me go!
You're exactly the same as your slutty mother! That disgusting bitch! Vanoxel made her lose her mind! She had to get in the way! I loved Ariana! Why did she keep us apart?
Mr. Ashman!
She had to be shown who was the real man! Did she not learn her lesson when I fucked her?
The fire extinguisher. Maybe I can use it to my advantage.
Ha! There you are!
Thank you.
have to leave this place at once.
So, Ariana and Felton pretended to be your parents for all this time? Come here, little one. Let Daddy hug you. Simon was right. We should have abandoned the project while we were still in time. Are you trying to piss me off? Acheron.
I am disgusted by you and all the girls of your generation. I will rip your head off and throw it in the freezer.
Hang her. She's all yours. Do what you want.
lady. Did your mother tell you that you were born because I fucked her?
Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock!
It was never enough for that fucking whore. The hypnosis, the drugs, her daddy's money, and the company. No. She stole from me the woman I loved. And if that wasn't enough, she stained my family's name.
And what about you? Wasn't fucking your sister enough for you?
Don't you dare talk about Gloria that way!
You're a fucking monster! Admit it! They kept her isolated, far away from anyone, just so that she couldn't spill all of your dirty family secrets!
You don't know shit!
And when it all started to resurface, you decided it was time to shut them up! Maybe by lighting it all up!
Shut up!
It's the most idiotic story I've ever heard. Did your dearest father tell you that in reality he was a woman? That he married the woman that I loved just to keep up the act? That at just 10 years of age, his father stuffed him with meds? You weren't adopted! You best convince yourself that Felton is your biological mother! Give up! There's nothing you can do.
Come on.
You can hear me. You can do it. Concentrate. Release what you are holding inside of you. You are Mother Acherontia. The moths are listening to you. What you have is not an illness. It's a gift. A gift. Use it. You can do it. Sir, quickly, it's coming from the cold room. I think the lights went out.
They're coming!
Sir, the girl. I can't find her.
If only this whole project had gone up...
Kiss my ass, dickhead!
Be it this mess! Open this fucking door, you...
They're all crazy! Crazy!
You shall respect me! Mom, Dad, Gloria, I am so sorry.
Careful from now on. Dear God, please help me. Not you too, Elisa. Not you too.
We can't. We can't leave. I'm only a victim in all of this. Jennifer, why are you doing this?
Did I teach you good manners at the Flemington Institute?
The balcony. I knew this wasn't just a bad dream. I wasn't losing my mind. Shit!
I thought I'd made myself clear. Surprise! I will make you regret ever being born!
I've been hurt. I have to hide.
You and Lindsay have fun together? Did you watch it? The others not to lower their guard. Thank you.
Girls, could all of this have something to do with me?
Did they not teach you good manners at the Flemington Institute? Are you having fun? Managed to enchant me. She's just like Felton, that whore.
They're coming.
Hey, you! Come here! Stop! Naughty girl!
I beg you!
Aha!
Guys.
That's enough running! think you're still going to be able to run away to that talent contest?
Jennifer?
You're just
don't
like,
make me lose my patience.
Filthy bitch! How did she get away?
I'm here, working my ass off.
My God, I have to leave this place at once.
It would be best if I just...
Noxle was our only option to achieve what we all wanted. And that was to forget about everything. It's all her fault!
I can't take it anymore!
Ariana, how could you do this to me? Was our only option to achieve what we all wanted. And that was to forget about everything.
Well, they're wandering.
Wyman was right. We should have abandoned the project.
I don't want to die. I don't want to die.
Wasn't supposed to end like this.
A break from it all.
The only one who asked. I can't take it anymore. It's a nightmare.
Why me? Why?
Felton, Wyman, you both are responsible for this mess. How did you manage to enchant me? She's just like Felton, that whore. Wyman! You both are responsible for this mess! We thought we could stop them. To stop the parasite from spreading. And instead, it all turned against us.
Leave this place at once.
my head. It's all her fault.
Working my ass off. Filthy dog! What do you want now? Be quiet! Shut your mouth!
Oh no!
No! Any work done around here is me. I told Ashman that we didn't need desperate children. Anyone who actually gets any work done around here is me.
She's running away! She's running away!
I beg you! I beg you!
Listen to me. There's no time now.
I want to get away from this place!
Okay, I can help you escape, but you have to help me with something first. Jennifer, you have to trust me. I know what you are capable of, like what you did in the cold room.
That voice, was that you earlier on?
I can feel what you are holding inside, and I know that you can hear me. Listen up. There's a dumbwaiter in the utility room on the balcony. I know how to find the key, but you have to guide me.
Guide you? And how would I do that?
Exactly how I did with you earlier. I guided you to use your gift, allowing you to escape. Stay here. I'll go ahead. Concentrate. Look inside yourself. Okay, stay with me. Don't leave me. I'll give you the go-ahead as soon as I'm done. Run outside and come meet me. Shit, she's coming this way. Do you see that old jukebox? Use it. Here we are. There should be a key somewhere. Ashman usually hides it here. Where the fuck is it? God damn it, I can't get to it. Can you manage to see a small key up there?
She heard me. Oh, God, I have to hide. Jen, what do I do? Stay with me. Don't leave me. I'll give you the go-ahead as soon as I'm done. Run outside and come meet me. Shit, she's coming this way. Do you see that old jukebox? Use it. Get to it! Can you manage to see a small key up there? No! She heard me! Oh God, I have to hide! Jen, what do I do?
To Elisa, now! What the hell is going on? Who the fuck was that?
You've heard of the fire at the convent, haven't you? Well, not all of them died.
Gloria Ashman.
Jennifer, you have to help us, I beg you. We are trapped in a hypnotic loop. As soon as the loudspeaker starts ticking, our minds go back into a limbo.
I don't understand. What can I possibly do?
That thing lives down there. It has no effect on you. You can end the loop.
There is much time left. I beg you, please. It's in my head. I can't get out of the loop. Has no effect done you. You can end the loop. Stop it. It's part of all of us. And we are part of the same thing.
Of the same thing.
So close when the night was fast, you
so
and
close
me. When the night was fast, you and me.
Oh dear, sorry, I thought I was alone.
No, please, continue.
I prefer not to, really.
I'm Jennifer, by the way.
Lindsay? But call me Lynn.
I'm sorry for earlier on.
Don't worry about it. I was too intrusive.
And I extremely rude.
Oh, well, truce.
Truce. What were you doing here?
I was just singing. I usually play the violin, but they locked it away as soon as I got here.
If you can play the violin even as half as well as you can sing, then you're a fucking master.
Nothing special.
You got a great voice. And that song. Did you write it?
I'm still working on it.
I got an idea. There's a festival for artists with original songs. The winner gets a full scholarship at the conservatory. Here, look. The performance will take place in a theater. I say you should go for it.
No. There's no way I would ever be capable of something like that.
Why did you say that?
First off, we're stuck here. Second, singing and playing the violin at the same time is too complicated. I could never do it on my own.
I could do it with you. I play the piano. Listen, we can do this.
I don't know, Jen. I don't know. And how would we even get there?
We could talk to Ashwin about it.
Yeah, dream on. It's only 2 weeks away.
We can work on it together. All we need is a music sheet and a bit of practice. I know the piano so well that it's basically a part of me.
But the lyrics are nowhere near finished.
My father used to tell me that nothing, not even time, can get in the way of something you truly desire.
Where are you from?
It's not a nice story.
Hmm.
You see, the whole point of the game is not to miss the basket.
Woohoo! Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner!
Abdul Jabbar?
Leave this body!
Have you ever tried one?
Sure, why not? Fuck it.
When the smoke is about to enter your throat, you exhale. Do you believe in fate? This song.
I love it.
Did you know they made it for a movie?
Seriously?
You bet. Before Saying Goodbye, it was a great hit in the 60s. Have you never heard of it?
No.
My parents brought me to the cinema to see it. As soon as we got home, my father taught me how to play the theme song on the piano.
Would you like it if we were to watch it together one day?
You bet. What am I doing? Don't give up now, Jen.
I can hear you. I can feel what you are feeling. I am in your head. You keep getting closer and closer. But what are you planning to do? Stop me. You will fail. As did all those who came before you.
What is this place? Oh my God! No, no! Murderers! Fucking murderers!
It's not too late. Turn back, little girl. Lie away. Go. Way.
Like the reception of an old hospital, or something similar. Various documents and newspaper extracts. It almost looks like a sociopath's hideout. Him again, Professor Wyman. Oh, Jesus, he makes my stomach turn. Oh my
here.
Thank you.
something switched on. Wyman couldn't possibly have used the business's finances to fund the experiments without someone noticing, which means that Ashman knew everything. No wonder. While everyone thought you were dead, you were down here, playing the role of the happy surgeon. This is how it all started. Gloria managed to obtain control of the other nuns, becoming Mother Acruntia.
Phenoxyl. Created as a byproduct of synthesizing the moth parasite known as Acherontia, its use leads to a parasitic infection. By emulating the moth's behavior, phenoxyl can result in a collective hypnosis, in which multiple individuals are forced to obey a leader or a Mother Acherontia. Collective hypnosis. The leader uses a person known as the medium as a channel and amplifier for other subjects. When the medium is surrounded by mirrors to simulate a fragmentation of the mind, the parasites awaken and spread. The start. The leader uses a recall element for the medium called the anchor. This can be a nursery rhyme or a song, and it's this that initiates the hypnosis. The leader acquires full control over everyone else through the medium. A collective consciousness starts. The ending. The leader can interrupt the loop by awakening the medium with a push, another nursery rhyme or a song. When the infected subjects and the medium wake, everything that happened during the hypnotic phase is forgotten. The collective consciousness breaks. The fracture. If a collective hypnosis is abruptly interrupted, there is a risk of fracture, also called the porcelain phase. Here, the leader's consciousness becomes fragmented and is then absorbed by the medium. The body of the leader becomes wholly controlled by the Acherontia, while the leader's mind remains trapped inside the medium, gradually unable to control his own body. Meanwhile, the parasite continues its expansion in the infected subjects. Collective hypnosis will occur regularly until another potential leader intervenes to break the looping cycle.
Oh dear, what happened? What's that? It looks like there's light coming from that wall. It's a hidden door. Bingo. Did Wyman really believe that it was possible to suppress pain or a disease with a fucking psychotropic? Is it supposed to be the myth of the super fucking man? Oh, they've all stopped.
Thank you.
to the projection room.
Thank you.